Rudy Giuliani is ramping up the legal battle against suspected voter fraud committed by the Democrat Party. Today, President Trump's attorney said the Trump campaign will likely file 4 or 5 more lawsuits by the end of the week. These would call into question allegations of fraudulent ballots, removals of poll watchers, and ballot dumping, all of which may have given an unfair advantage to Joe Biden. Biden has declared himself president-elect, although the vote tabulation process is still underway. Giuliani says President Trump is right not to concede to the election.
If it were a fair process, even by Fox, that would have been called for him, particularly since they called Virginia very early on with a very small sample of the vote. With Trump actually ahead in Virginia, they called it for Biden. Only Fox did.
Giuliani expects these formal complaints to start being filed as soon as Monday. Meantime, Giuliani tells One America's White House correspondent Jenn Pellegrino he has the evidence to prove that this election isn't over yet.
Joining me now is America's Mayor Rudy Giuliani, host of the Common Sense podcast, an attorney for the president that is working tirelessly to ensure that we have an honest election. Mr. Mayor, thank you for taking time this morning.
Thank you, Jen. Thank you very much.
So I want to talk to you about the press conference you held yesterday. You said that the mainstream media, they're not the ones that decide this election. The courts do in this situation. Can you tell us what you have uncovered leading up until now that will be decided in the courts?
Every state requires that a Republican and a Democrat observe the counting. In Philadelphia, at least 130,000, we went to court, we got an order to allow us closer, 6 feet closer. And when that order was brought to the sheriff moved us 6 feet closer, and he moved the people 10 feet further away. And when we objected to that, he threatened to arrest us. So, end result, we never got to see any of 135,000 ballots. Biden won the state by less than 40,000. I mean, those ballots, those 135,000 ballots must be disqualified by the court because they were entered into the rolls in direct violation of state law. In Pittsburgh, we have a similar situation. Might amount to as much as 300,000 ballots, but whatever it is, those ballots will also have to be disqualified, already way beyond a number that would flip the state from Biden, who stole the votes, to Trump, who earned the votes. Now, that doesn't count the situations where votes were backdated. We have evidence that votes were backdated. So it said November 4th, they wrote down November 3rd. It said November 5th, they wrote down November 2nd and put it in a pile, took the envelope away, and then entered it into the votes. We also have now a growing number of dead people that voted in Philadelphia. You remember the heavyweight champion, Joe Frazier? He died 8 years ago. He voted 2 years ago. The actor Will Smith has a grandfather who died about 4 years ago. He's voted in the last two elections. And that number now is growing. I think it's up to 700 dead people who voted in Philadelphia.
So I just want to confirm, sir, you do have evidence. The mainstream media says there's no evidence of this whatsoever.
I know the mainstream media says there's no evidence. And there I was at a press conference with 10 witnesses behind me. And I pointed out that the mainstream media never went to law school, and they don't understand that witnesses equal evidence. So the mainstream media is, as usual, lying or incredibly ignorant.
You know, what's your level of confidence that the evidence that you have, plus evidence in other states that's going to come forward, what's your confidence that this will change the course of the election and keep President Trump in the White House for another 4 years?
I'm pretty confident. I mean, the one I can be the most confident of right now, Pennsylvania, I see all the evidence. We're very close to that in Michigan and in Georgia. I haven't taken a look at the other states yet. I'm about to do that this afternoon. We're either going to win Arizona, or there are already enough challenges that I think we'll be able to overturn it. Arizona's going to be within 10,000 votes one way or the other. So you put all those states together, I think we change this election, we get the actual awful result, which is that I actually think President Trump won this election pretty handily. and the amount of cheating that was involved is historic.
Want to see more videos like this? Visit OANN.com for immediate access to all the clips you've been waiting to see.